What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome to a brand new Liverpool transfer news video. And in this video we will have another major update in the Thiago Alcantara to Liverpool transfer story, because there has been another journalist who is claiming that Thiago is set to join Liverpool and agree a four-year deal next week. And also there was the German Cup final, which Bayern Munich won in emphatic fashion 4-2. Both Thiago and Coutinho came on as substitutes, and Thiago actually posted a picture of himself and former Liverpool player Coutinho with the DFB Pokal, the trophy itself. And that was probably a cheeky picture to get Liverpool fans talking. So Thiago is hinting at leaving Bayern Munich and joining Liverpool on his own Twitter account. And also there was a video emerging where Thiago Alcantara basically was crying in the trophy celebrations, hugging one of the assistant coaches of Bayern Munich, and he looked like he was in tears, because that was probably his final game, his farewell appearance for Bayern Munich. And in this video we will talk about more on that, and also we will talk about Curtis Jones and big news around his new contract. So guys, if you enjoy these, leave a like and subscribe, turn on the bell notification so you never miss the latest Liverpool transfer update. So Bayern Munich CEO Karl-Heinz Rummenigge himself said that Bayern Munich will sell Thiago Alcantara in the summer, because Thiago wanted to try a new league. He's going to the Premier League. Liverpool are very heavy favorites because Jurgen Klopp is a huge fan of Thiago Alcantara. Jurgen Klopp himself said previously that he is a world-class player, and I think Thiago wants to experience something new. Karl-Heinz Rummenigge, the Bayern CEO, confirmed that Thiago wants a new challenge. He already won 7 Bundesliga titles with Bayern Munich, so Thiago wants a new challenge. And now let's talk about this South American journalist who is called Jorge Baravalle, who works for Fox Sports, and the broadcaster also claims that Thiago is set to join Liverpool as early as next week. And he actually tweeted, this South American journalist, this: if something was missing from Jurgen Klopp's Liverpool team to be more attractive, it is to incorporate Thiago Alcantara into the squad and to hone his skills, take advantage of Thiago Alcantara's ball playing skills. The arrival of the Bayern Munich player will be announced next week. He will sign a 4-year contract, Thiago, and he will become a Liverpool player. And I mean, according to some people, this is a very well respected radio host in South America, and he wouldn't lie. It looks like South America seems to be the prime source for all this transfer news around Thiago Alcantara joining Liverpool, and he is very reliable according to other people. He got the Alonso from Lille to Atletico Mineiro transfer news early on. He broke that transfer story early on. Very good, reliable journalist. So he is most likely just announcing that information that has been relayed to him, maybe from some other people. Thiago Alcantara, yes, he's Spanish, but he has Brazilian heritage, Brazilian ancestors, and of course he probably has some ties to Brazil. Thiago, maybe his family lives there, and maybe he already told his family that he is negotiating with Liverpool. And according to some journalists, Thiago actually already agreed personal terms with Liverpool, and now it's up to Liverpool to agree a transfer fee with Bayern Munich, and we are in the process of negotiating with Bayern Munich, and they could agree a 30-31 million pound deal for Thiago Alcantara, who is 29 years old. And yes, I get that he is not the usual age bracket that Liverpool are going for in the transfer market, but 29 is not exactly old. In a football terms, he still has a good 3-4 years at the very top of European football, and that's the same amount of time that Jurgen Klopp has left on his Liverpool contract. And if Jurgen Klopp wants to maximize winning trophies in his last 4 years at Liverpool, why not sign a very experienced, absolute winner of a midfielder like Thiago Alcantara who can absolutely help Liverpool win more trophies, because he is a very, very creative ball-playing midfielder, deep-lying midfielder, who can play as an attacking midfielder, as a defensive midfielder. He can play all across the midfield in various different positions. And I think that Thiago Alcantara, with the experience he has, I mean, he already won the Champions League. He also won 7 Bundesliga titles with Bayern Munich. So he has absolutely incredible experience. And I think he wants to experience a new challenge. I mean, Bayern themselves confirmed this. He didn't win the Champions League with Bayern Munich. He won it with Barcelona in 2011. But he won everything else with Bayern Munich. And he probably wants to win the Champions League again. And why not at Liverpool? Liverpool are one of the favorites to win the Champions League next season. And with Thiago, we will be even stronger. Liverpool scouts were present on the German Cup final day between Bayern Munich and Leverkusen, and they were watching, of course, rumored Liverpool targets Thiago Alcantara and Kai Havertz. And Kai Havertz actually scored a penalty in the 95th minute, but it was already 4-1 Bayern, so it didn't really matter. And there has been little to no coverage on Liverpool's interest in Leon Bailey, for example, but it looks like that Sky Sports are claiming that Liverpool are keeping an eye on Leon Bailey as well. So I might make a separate video on that player, just to give you guys more information on what he could bring to Liverpool. But I think this is definitely something to keep an eye on. And of course, we have been watching Thiago Alcantara, and I'm sure that Jurgen Klopp already knows full well what a good player is. And what I find very, very impressive is that Thiago Alcantara is very rarely injured, even though he has been sometimes a substitute in this season. I mean, he already played 36 games this season. Last season he played 42, the season before that 32, then 41, 42. So he has a lot of games under his belt, and he's very experienced. And even at Barcelona he had seasons where he played 45 games and 36 games. So he's a player who is very reliable, I think, and he could start a lot of games for Liverpool. I think we need more options. Wijnaldum still hasn't signed a contract extension, but there are rumors that he is actually close to agreeing a new contract. According to Football Insider, contract talks with Wijnaldum are progressing well enough to give hope that it could be over the line in the next few weeks, so probably expect an announcement before the end of the season on Wijnaldum's contract situation. And also, it looks like that Van Dijk is in line for a new bumper, new contract as well. Harvey Elliott is very close to agreeing a new contract. But what is absolutely brilliant news is that Curtis Jones signed a new 5-year Liverpool contract extension. The 19-year-old midfielder has featured on 8 occasions this season, and his talents have convinced Liverpool to retain him until 2029, which is absolutely brilliant news. And Curtis Jones is definitely good enough to play for Liverpool. He scored an absolute belter of a winning goal against Everton in the FA Cup, and he will be forever famous for that goal. But I think he can score a lot more goals in the future. Hopefully Curtis Jones will become like almost as good as Steven Gerrard in his prime. We shall wait and see. But he has similar characteristics as Steven Gerrard, as a box-to-box attacking midfielder who can score goals, who can get assists, and who can just get about on the pitch. And all he needs now is Premier League experience. Jurgen Klopp said this about Curtis Jones extending his contract with five years, which is absolutely huge. Really pleased about this, absolutely deserved. This is a little different to the announcement we made last year when Curtis Jones signed his last contract. That was about both the player and the club making a long-term commitment to each other. Today's news is more about reward. When Curtis signed, we made promises to him that if he continued to improve and grow as a player, then we would make sure we recognize that, and that is what we have now done. That is our way here. We want our young players to achieve their maximum, and a big part of that is keeping the focus on their journey and not just a destination. You have to make sure their development is constant, otherwise you are failing them. I could not be more pleased and proud to see how he has blossomed. Super attitude, brilliant application, and a really important member of this squad now. His quality is not in doubt, technically and ability-wise at the highest level, but plenty of young players have the skills. It's about more than that. if you want to achieve potential, and Curtis is showing it. For Curtis now, it's about continuing his improvement. If he does that, he can achieve anything he wants in the game. I think we are the perfect environment for him. So it's a very cool situation. I love it that our supporters will be able to enjoy having more than one Scouser in our team. And yeah, Curtis Jones is also a Scouser just like Trenrox Ronald. So that is absolutely brilliant. And Curtis Jones himself gave an interview after signing that new 5-year contract. Basically, he gets a wage rise, so a longer contract. And he said this, it's come around quick. I think it was only a year to 10 months ago when I first signed my other contract, but I've done well and I'm proud to have got another one. It was an easy thing for me to be able to put pen to paper and try and get it done as quick as possible. I'm very proud to stay at Liverpool. As everyone knows, it's massive for me. As you said, then, it's my boyhood club, it's the whole of my family's club as well. For me, it's huge. I think the environment, the staff is all positive and keeps me as positive as I can. Of course, we are working with a great manager and around the best team in the world. So for me, it was easy and I'm extremely proud to sign a new contract with Liverpool. I think for any of the young lads, including myself, you come here, you work hard, we work hard every day. The manager, the team have got that faith and belief in us. The opportunities that we have got have been huge throughout the whole season. I think I've took my chance well and it's repaid me in a great way. It's a perfect environment. I've got great boys around that help me every day. Henderson, Milner, Lallana, Fabinho, the whole of the team is perfect for me to watch every day in training. But to be involved with them, you pick up so many things and the detail in what they do, and they do everything perfect. Their professionalism around the place, it's perfect. So I'm picking up all that and taking it into my game. And to me as a person, it's paying off right. I haven't really soaked up the title win yet. I think the boys are doing very well and the games are coming as quick as possible. I don't want to sit there and try and put it all on me, because I think without the boys and the coaching staff around, I wouldn't have got those opportunities and wouldn't have been able to live that dream I've had to play for Liverpool. I need to give credit to the boys and the rest of the coaching staff, most likely. I'm just a young lad and I'm in the world's best team, definitely. The things I'm picking up every single day and the people that I'm learning from will definitely benefit me in the future. It's a dream as a young lad growing up who loved football. It was always my dream to come here and spend the whole of my career here. I'm here to make history at the club and try and be a legend at the club and want to be remembered by the whole of the fan base throughout the whole time that Liverpool FC lasts. And this is the absolute dream of every Liverpool fan, in my opinion, to come to Liverpool as a Liverpool-born Scouser, and absolutely, like, Curtis Jones is living the dream of many Liverpool fans, I'm sure, and I think he wants to stay at Liverpool for all his life and become the next Jamie Carragher, the next Steven Gerrard, even the next Trent Alexander-Arnold, and hopefully he can do that. He can be successful enough and good enough to stay at Liverpool for the rest of his career, because then he fulfills his lifelong dream, which is absolutely brilliant. And he also said this, I'm a confident boy, but now I've got to be patient and wait until the time's right, and wait until the manager and his staff think it's right time to put me in, which I know they will, because I know the belief that they've got to in me, and I know they are perfect people to be around at the moment I am now in my career. As I always say, anytime that I'm called upon, and any position that I get put on in, I will always give 100%. As I said before, I'm here to make history at the club. I came in at the same age as what Harvey is now, and him coming in, you can already see how well that he is fit in and how confident he is. But the same is for me, Neco Williams, Kiana Hoover, the rest of the young lads that are in there now. It's perfect. You come in, you are made welcome every single day. But of course, the boys expect a lot from me, because you are so young and you are up here for a reason. Of course, there's a lot asked, but that pays off for you in the future. I think the changing room is perfect, and the team that I've got around us now at the minute is absolutely perfect. Once I sign, I don't really think about anything else, my long-term future. I just want to go out on the pitch and be the best I can and show everybody the player that I'm going to be in the future. As soon as I signed, now I'm straight back out there, 100% working again. As I said before, I'm looking forward to the opportunities that the manager and the rest of the staff will be giving. And Jurgen Klopp talked about the young players stepping up and becoming regular first team players. And he said, Curtis Jones said, it's huge. Not only is it a dream, but whenever I'm challenged, I love a challenge, especially now with the team that I'm in. I'm battling every day to try and get in the team or be on the bench or be around the squad. Every opportunity that I get, I will definitely be taking it with both hands and giving it the best shot that I've got. That's what I think I've done in the games that I've played. And definitely I need to earn my opportunities. Everybody knows now that the team we are trying to get in is the best team in the world. The players that are in there are world class. For me, I've got to be 100% focused and give it 100% every single day that I'm in here and keep doing my extra work that I'm doing around training. Oh my goodness, what a brilliant interview by Curtis Jones. I absolutely love him and I love that he signed a new 5-year contract. And Jurgen Klopp said that even after losing to Manchester City 4-0 and winning the title before that, we cannot press the pause button even for 1 second. This is what Jurgen Klopp said. One of our defining features as a team has been to embody the spirit of the line in the supporters' song Ale 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 when they declare, we are never gonna stop. I love everything about that line. This team has embraced that mentality. We have achieved much together, but we cannot press the pause button for even one moment. It is important to savor and enjoy the special moments. It is not allowed that we don't recognize these shared experiences, but it is possible if you have the mindset to do both. Enjoy the now, but be in a hungry and greedy mood for the future and for more in the future. I keep getting asked about dynasty and dominance, and I really don't like it. One headline since we came back wrongly suggested it was our plan to build a dynasty. I've never said this and I never would. If we remain humble and as individuals, as a team and as a club, we can achieve so much more together. And being humble isn't about not celebrating. Trust me, I'm a big fan of celebrating like crazy. Humility is about how you approach your work. For me, it's about recognizing that I need to improve as a coach and a leader and find ways to be better. For my players, it was about being prepared to work even harder than you have before. Titles don't make players. Their day-to-day work does that. Their attitude does that. Their ability to be humble and accept they are not perfect and can be better. Those things do that. And for our fans, it's about recognizing that their role will always be critical to everything we do, and they need to keep being our energy source. Wow. Jurgen Klopp always does and says the right things, and I absolutely love that about him. That was another absolutely brilliant interview by him, and I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I had a lot of fun making it. Thanks for watching. See you later, guys. Goodbye.